The next thing we have to talk about is how can we dynamically increase the amount of physical memory that's available to a particular operating system running on top of the hypervisor. As I mentioned, memory requirements tend to be bursty, and therefore the hypervisor has to be able to allocate real physical memory or machine memory on demand to the requesting guest operating systems on top of it. Let's look at this picture here. Let's assume that this is the total amount of machine memory that's available to the hypervisor, and the hypervisor has divvied up the available machine memory among these two operating systems. So the house, meaning the hypervisor, has no spare memory at all. It is completely divided up and given to these two guys. What if the Windows operating system experiences a burst in memory usage, and therefore it's requiring more memory from the hypervisor? It may happen because of some resource-hungry application that has been started up in Windows, maybe a video streaming application that is gobbling up a lot of physical memory, and therefore Windows needs more memory, and it comes to the hypervisor asking for additional hardware resources. But unfortunately, the bank is empty. What the hypervisor could do is recognize that, well, maybe this operating system doesn't need all of the physical resources I allocated it. So I'm going to grab back a portion of the physical memory that Linux has. And once I get back this portion of physical memory that I previously allocated to Linux, I can then give it to Windows to satisfy its sudden hunger for more memory. Well, this principle of robbing Peter to pay Paul can lead to unexpected and anomalous behavior of applications running on the guest operating system. A saner approach, of course, would be to coax one of the guest operating systems, in this case perhaps Linux, to give up some of its physical memory voluntarily to satisfy the needs of a peer that is currently experiencing memory pressure.